Hi, this is Sydney Friedberg, Deputy Editor at Breaking Defense, here at the Mammoth Association of the U.S. Army Annual Show and Defense Trade Conference. I'm here with Dave Dearson, Vice President at Oshkosh, to talk about the new Jeep, essentially, of the U.S. Army, the Joint Light Tactical Vehicle, and all the different systems they're able to put on it.
Hey, welcome, Sydney, to our booth here at Oshkosh Defense. What we've got here and behind us is our Oshkosh JLTV utility variant. It's a two-seat variant replacing the up-armored Humvee. And what we showed integrated on the vehicle right now is a SHORAD system made by Boeing.
So short-range anti-aircraft defense is something that the Army has lost a lot of capability and is now trying to build back as it looks at threats like the Soviet, the ex-Soviets, the Russians with their Hind helicopters and so forth.
Correct, that's exactly it. And what we wanted to demonstrate on here, not only is, you know, other industry partners out there looking at solving that problem on SHORAD, we want to show the flexibility of our JLTV to be able to integrate that type of a system very rapidly and quickly for different mission sets should they need them.
So talk about the three things on here. That there's the sensors to actually find the target, and then there's the gun, and then there's the missile system.
Yep, exactly. So what we see back here, you've got a standard machine gun system on it. You've got a sensor package to, as you stated, find the target, lock on the target, and so forth. And then this one has got the Longbow Hellfire missile system attached to it, which could be changed out with different missiles and so forth. It's a standard M299 launcher system that they've got on there.
Now, the Longbow originally is attacked ground target, so can this both attack a ground target, like a tank and a helicopter or aircraft?
That is correct. I mean, they've made some upgrades over the last few years, and that's one of the capabilities of this, not only from the Stinger missile, but for the Longbow Hellfire. They can do the same thing.
Here, looking at the new Jeep, essentially, for the U.S. Army, the Joint Light Tactical Vehicle, and all the different weapons and other cool stuff that manufacturer Oshkosh can put on it. So what do you put on this vehicle? I know the 30mm heavy cannon was something you'd worked on before, but now we have that funky bit of optics in the back. So what does that do and what does it add?
Yeah, so what we've got on the rear end of the vehicle here in conjunction with the 30mm is a compact laser weapon system. So it's an Oshkosh system, it's made by Boeing. So this system is designed for multiple like UAV, UAS type threat scenarios.
Drones.
Drones, exactly, where you could potentially either shoot them down, dazzle them, just give that commander additional flexibility. Because that's what really the platform is all about, that flexibility for integration different systems.
Why would a commander want both the 30mm gun for, you know, ground targets and the laser for those drones on the same system?
Well, it really depends. Depends on the mission, depends what they're going to do. All we're doing is providing that flexibility. You know, they don't have to have them both at the same time. They can have one different or put in a completely different weapon system on that. So from an operational perspective, we really don't want to discuss what how they may employ them. We're just showing that these are the capabilities and the flexibility the platform can absorb and support for different mission requirements that are out there now and will be there for the future.
And did you have to do anything to boost the vehicle's power to generate the energy if the laser needs to fire?
No, the way this system is set up, it's got a cooler system, it's got a energy storage system, and it's got a control system. So all we had to do on this, actually, is to identify that space claim on the vehicle, let the vehicle then charge up that system and recharge as need be. So it really is just an integration issue for the platform itself. We didn't really have to make any major adjustments for the platform to support it.
Thanks very much.